First of all, the revelation that there were traces of THC, a byproduct of marijuana, inside Trayvon Martin's body from the autopsy. What do you make of that? Is it significant? Is it relevant?
There's no significance that there was trace amounts of marijuana in Trayvon Martin's system. Pierce, what's really relevant is the fact that there was no toxicology report done on Jarre Zimmerman, and we don't know what else was in his system with the prescribed medications that he was on to have him get out of his car in the rain and profile, pursue, and confront Trayvon Martin, and then kill Trayvon Martin in cold blood, even though he was unarmed. And so the trace amounts of marijuana is irrelevant.
The second point is this photograph, quite fascinating. It seems to have been taken in the back of the car after Jarre Zimmerman is being taken to the police station from the scene of the incident, in which it's a fairly grainy photograph, but it quite clearly appears to show that Jarre Zimmerman's nose looks like it's been broken. Now, what do you think of that, particularly in light of the fact that later video from the station doesn't seem to show that? So should we be taking this at literally face value?
Well, again, you have to put it in context, Pierce. Jarre Zimmerman pursued and confronted Trayvon Martin after he profiled him and initiated an altercation. We believe Trayvon Martin went to his grave not knowing who this strange man was that was confronting him. And Trayvon Martin was fighting for his life. He was fighting a man with a 9mm gun, and he was in a fight for his life. Tragically, he lost the fight, and he tried to defend himself. It was self-defense for Trayvon Martin. If Jarre Zimmerman suffered a superficial injuries, Trayvon Martin suffered a fatal injury. Jarre Zimmerman did not have to go to the hospital that night for his injuries. Trayvon Martin certainly was taken away in an ambulance. Jarre Zimmerman did not leave in an ambulance.